My name is Priyanka Kulkarni and today we will be learning about perimetry, that is the method to determine the peripheral field of vision, and the instrument that we use is a perimeter. Let us look at the principle. So what is field of vision? Field of vision is the part of external world that you can see when one eye is closed and the gaze is fixed at a particular point or object. So we have four field of visions, the four sides. This is the temporal, this is nasal, this is superior, and this is inferior. The temporal has a field of vision of 100 degrees. It is because it is maximum, because there is no anatomical obstruction. On the nasal side, it is obstructed by the nasal bridge, and that is why it is 60 degrees. Superiorly, we have the supraorbital margin. Hence, it is 55 degrees, which is the least. And inferiorly, the anatomical obstruction is the maxilla of the cheek, which makes it 75 degrees. We will be calculating all the field of vision for all these sides and locate the blind spot. This is the chin rest. This is the right side and this is the left cuff. So if we want to measure the field of vision for the right eye, then ask the subject to keep his or her chin on the left side. This is the rod which we use to align the eye towards the central white point. This is the tip of the rod which we need to align at the lower eyelid of the subject. This is the metallic arc which is movable, and it is graduated from 0 degrees in the center to 90 degrees at the periphery. And this is the object that we will be using to calculate the field of vision. It has got a white circle. It has got circles in the center of different sizes. We will be using the circle of maximum size, and there are different colors. We will be using the white color because it has the maximum visual acuity. At the back side of this disc, this is the disc which we use to fix the perimetry chart, and this is the scale used to mark the points. Over here, there is a screw which we can use to tighten or make the metallic arc loose. Let us start with the procedure. So I will first ask my subject to sit comfortably on the chair, and we will be measuring the field of vision for the right eye. So I will ask the subject to keep the chin on the left chin cup, and then we will adjust its height so that the tip of this rod matches the lower eyelid, and then we will tighten the screw. Perimetry chart. As we can see, there is a central hole over here that corresponds to the visual axis of the eye. This over here is the visual field for the left eye, and this is the visual field for the right eye. The concentric circles that can be seen over here are called isopters, and they are present at an interval of 10 degrees each. These radii are known as meridians, placed at an interval of 15 degrees, and the small dots that you can see over here, that is the blind spot. To fix the perimetry chart, we will have to remove this screw first. And then we will remove this screw. Now we will pin the perimetry chart's center on this sharp point over here that we can see. Now we have fixed the perimetry chart over here. We have to fix it such that the temporal side comes to the right over here for the right eye. Now I will fix the screw. ask my subject to place her chin on the left chin cup because we want to calculate the field of vision for the right eye. Now, we will adjust the height of the chin rest so that it corresponds to the white tip of the rod, the lower lid, eyelid. Now, the lower eyelid corresponds to the white tip. Fix your gaze at this white point and cover your left eye. Fix your gaze on this white point over here and do not look around. Cover your left eye. So now the subject has covered her left eye. We have adjusted the chin rest and the gaze is fixed towards the central point. So we can now start with the procedure. Raise your hand when the white object over here becomes visible to you. Okay, so our reading is 80. We will mark the point for 80 over here. This was the reading and this point is 80. We have to repeat the same procedure at an interval of 15 degrees to mark for all the meridians. This is approximately 15 degrees. We will move from periphery towards the center. Can you see it? Now?
Yeah.
Okay. Raise your hand. So the reading over here is 75. Which is over here. Another 15 degrees. Can you see it?
Yeah.
Okay. So the reading over here is 70. We will mark the point at 70. Now this is the superior side. Raise your hand when you are able to see the object. Okay, so the reading is 60. In this drop, we can see 60 and now we will punch for this point. Repeat the same procedure for 15 degrees so that you will get for the nasal side over here and then for the inferior side over here. Now we will have to calculate the field of vision for the left eye. So please keep your chin on the right chin rest and cover your right eye. The rod is fixed at the lower eyelid level. Fix your gaze at this central point, the central white point over here. Now we can start with the temporal side. For the left eye, this will be the temporal side, this will be the nasal side. Is it visible?
Yeah.
Okay, so our reading over here is 85. We will mark the point 85 over here. Now we will take the reading for every 15 degrees. Now let us map the blind spot on the right eye. For this, what we will do is, we will ask the subject when the white object becomes invisible. Now we will go ahead a little slowly.
Not visible.
Is it visible?
No.
Still? Okay. So the reading is 25. We will mark the point over here. Now tell me when you can see the point once again.
Yeah,
visible.
Yeah.
Okay. So the reading is slightly ahead of 20. We'll consider it 20. Now, we will keep the object in between the two points, that is 20 and 25 over here. Now, we will shift it slightly upwards and ask the subject when the object becomes visible again.
Yeah, visible.
Okay, it is visible at this point. We will mark it. This is between 20 and 25. And slightly above. Okay. Now we will do the same on the inferior side. Can you see it now? Okay. This is our blind spot. So after mapping all the spots, this is how the perimetry chart looks like. This green outline can show us the visual field for the right side, for the right eye, and the blue one is the visual field for the left eye. This circle over here represents the blind spot for right eye, and this is the blind spot for left eye. Blind spot is nothing but the region where rods and cones are absent and the optic nerve leaves the eyeball. Now let us look at the clinical aspect. So the peripheral field of vision decreases in glaucoma, and in the end stages of glaucoma, only the central field of vision remains. Secondly, we have anopia, that is blindness of the visual field. So we can have hemianopia or complete anopia, and in hemianopia, we have heteronymous anopia and homonymous anopia. So let us look at the cases in which we see this. So if there is a lesion in the right optic nerve, then what will happen is the fibers coming to the right eye will get blocked. So there will be complete blindness of the visual field for the right eye. Hence we call it ipsilateral. Why? Because it is on the same side. Ipsilateral anopia, ipsilateral complete anopia. Then if there is a lesion at the level of optic chiasma, then what will happen is fibers that cross at the level of optic chiasma are the ones on the medial side. Right, so the medial side will go and they will cross again at the level of eyeball and project into the temporal side. So for both the eyes, the nasal field of vision is normal, but on the temporal side we cannot see anything, the patient can't see. So what will we call this? Bitemporal heteronymous hemianopia. Why bitemporal? Because for both the eyes the temporal field of vision is not visible. And it is heteronymous because it is for the right side, for the right eye, and for the left side on the left eye. Then if there is a lesion at the level of the optic tract, say for example the right optic tract, then what will happen is that the lateral side will not be able to go, the lateral fibers will not be able to go to the lateral, the right eyeball, and the medial fibers will not be able to cross and go to the left eyeball. So there will be a homonymous hemianopia. Third point, scotomata. That is nothing but if the blind spot is present at a point other than the physiological scotoma, that is where the optic, at the level of optic disc where the optic nerve leaves. So if the blind spot is present at any other place than this, then it is known as scotomata, which is seen in glaucoma. Thank you for watching the video. Hope it helped, and all the best for your exams.